Welcome back, my dear children. How have you all been? Are you wondering which story I'm going to tell you today? Well, it is about the mongoose and the snake. We call this story in many names, such as the loyal mongoose, the mongoose and the farmer's wife, or the story of mongoose and the snake. So shall we start today's story? In nature, we find many natural enemies. These animals or birds or insects don't like each other and avoid being together. Sometimes they also fight until one of them dies. Some examples of these natural enemies are the crow and the hawks or owls, eagle and the snake, etc. Another example to be added to this list of natural enemies is mongoose and snakes. Mongoose are famous for attacking and killing snakes, especially cobra. So, mongoose were kept as a pet in the houses to protect against cobra. Long, long ago, there was a forest in a land far, far away. There was a small house in that forest. There lived a family of a farmer, his wife, and a small baby in that house. One day, when the farmer was coming back home from his farm, he finds a mongoose. He then remembers that his baby does not have any toys or pets to play with. So he brings the mongoose home. The farmer tells his wife, "Let us please keep this mongoose as our pet. He can be a good companion for the baby. The baby can play with the mongoose." The wife agrees and takes care of the mongoose. The baby was so happy that it starts playing with the mongoose. One day, after the farmer left the house, the wife finds that all the water she had stored was finished and there was no water in the house. So, she decides to fetch water from the river. She checks on the baby and sees that the baby is sleeping in the cradle. She tells the mongoose, "Dear mongoose, there is no one in the house. The baby is all alone in the house. Please stay by the side of the cradle and protect the baby. Do not leave the baby alone and go outside." Saying this, the wife leaves the house to fetch the water. As soon as she leaves, a black cobra snake that was outside the house sees the door open and starts crawling towards the house with great speed. The snake enters the house and sees the baby in the cradle. It swiftly goes towards the baby. The mongoose sees the snake going towards the cradle. It runs to the cradle to protect the baby. The mongoose jumps on the snakes and fights with it. The snake tries to bite mongoose, but the mongoose escapes and bites on the snake's mouth and hood. After a long fight, the snake gets tired and falls down. The mongoose kills the snake. There was red blood all around its mouth. Meanwhile, the wife returns home with water. The mongoose hears the sound of her bangles and runs towards her in joy. It was very happy that it killed the snake and protected the baby. But when the wife looks at the mongoose, all she sees was blood around its mouth. She screams, "Oh my God, blood, blood!" She does not notice that the mongoose was waiting for her in joy. She gets worried and thinks that the mongoose had killed her baby. She thinks that the blood on mongoose's mouth was the baby's blood. Crying in pain and anger, the wife throws the pot filled with water on mongoose with great force. She runs inside the house to check on the baby. She sees the baby playing in the cradle with joy. She also sees a dead cobra snake lying on the floor, covered in blood. The wife then understands what had happened. She realizes that the snake had gone to attack the baby and the mongoose had fought with the snake and killed it. She understands that the mongoose was a hero and he had protected the baby. She runs to check on the mongoose, but it was already very late. The mongoose was hurt when she had thrown the pot of water at it. The mongoose had died with blood covering all over its body. The wife was broken with pain and guilt. all of her sorry and tears could never bring back the mongoose. This finishes today's story, my dear children. So what did we learn today? We learned that we should never take decision in haste. It means that we should never take a decision when we are sad or angry. Sometimes, whatever we see or hear about others may not be true. Like for example, we may see a boy stealing food outside a shop, and we may want to punish him for that. But when we go and check it or talk to him, we may find that he had not stolen the food for himself, but he wanted to give it to his small brother or sister who was crying with hunger. So children, no matter what we see or hear, we should always inquire and think about it in calm mind before we make a decision. So, did you like today's story, children? If so, please click on the like button and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video, my dear children. Bye-bye.